ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930 present The Drive. Winner of the 2024 West Virginia Broadcasters Association Excellence in Broadcasting Award for Best Talk Show.
It is Monday, May 6th. Your drive begins now on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. I'm your host, Paul Swann. We're going to open up the text line this hour at 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Coming up, you know, the softball is about ready to go into tournament mode. So we've got coming up on the program this hour, we're going to hear from Brooklyn Ulrich. She's right now the RBI leader in the Sun Belt, and also Bub Feringa. Last year, Bub, 10 innings. This year, leads the team in innings pitched. So both of them are going to come on as we get ready for softball. The tournament is coming up starting on Wednesday in San Marcos, Texas. The fun thing about this is the Herd just wrapped up the series against Texas State, so they didn't have to go far. They might have a slight advantage over Georgia Southern. They've already beat Georgia Southern. They won the series a few weeks ago when it was here in Huntington. They won that series 2-1. So we've got softball coming up this hour. But I do want to hear from you. And again, that text line is 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Let's get you caught up in everything that happened this weekend. We got to start with baseball. Thundering Herd didn't finish off as strong as I would like to have, but the good news is the Herd won the series. There's still hope. They could have a postseason bid, as Georgia State did drill the Herd yesterday 17-8. So 2 out of 3, we'll take it. It's a series win. Marshall now will go into midweek baseball at Jack Cook Field Wednesday. 6 o'clock will be against Ohio. And, of course, as I mentioned, Sun Belt Conference softball tournament play begins this week. The Herd, the 10th seed, that's the lowest the Herd has ever been seeded in softball. We had to go look that up a little bit. We did not know it was that low. They had never been that low. And you would think, oh, surely they've been maybe one or a couple times they've been low. No, this is the lowest they've ever been. So they've got a lot to prove. We'll hear a little bit about it when we have Brooklyn on here in the next few minutes. What else happened? Of course, talking about softball, as I mentioned, the Thundering Herd, despite falling at Texas State, were able to get that 10 spot. They started the weekend, they were the 7 seed, but they lost 3 straight there, so they fell to the 10 seed. So they end up playing the 7 seed. So they really didn't lose too much. They could have maybe moved up a little bit, but they didn't lose too much as they are going to play in the second game. That's a good team in Texas State. They're receiving votes. They're pretty good. Maybe Marshall can get hot. We've seen Marshall do that before in the softball tournament. They've gotten hot, and they've been able to really make a run at it. It's been a while since they've won a championship, so they came so close last year. It was unfortunate they couldn't get it done. And then, of course, Megan Smith-Lyon leaving, Morgan Zirkel now taking the reins of the team. She's got some experience. Postseason is not new to her, so she's got some experience there. Baseball action, we got a game coming up tonight. Pirates taking on the Angels. That is set for a 6:15 airtime right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. Pirates starting to maybe warm up a little bit. They beat the Rockies 5-3 yesterday, so they've got the home series against the Angels tonight. And we've got that game again right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. Reds got drilled against the Orioles yesterday. Orioles beat them 11-1. Reds have got the day off. Guardians beat the Angels 4-1. Cleveland hosting Detroit tonight, 6:10 there. And talking about minor league baseball, checking in on what's happening with Charleston. The Dirty Birds beat Gastonia 8-7. Dirty Birds off to a 7-3 start. So good times are happening in Charleston with the Dirty Birds. They might get a shot this year. Speaking of teams that might have a shot, I don't know how deep they're going to go, but Cleveland got it done, beating Orlando first round of the NBA playoffs 106-94. Cavaliers are going to take on Boston in the second round. This is the first series, believe it or not, first series that the Cavs have won since LeBron James left the team. They haven't won a first-round series since LeBron James left. And before that, we got to go back a ways, dig in the record books here. But hey, LeBron's not in the playoffs. He's out. The Cavs are in. Who would have thought that? Again, getting it done, finally standing on their own without LeBron. Should be a fun series against Boston. So what everyone do this weekend? I know we had Cinco de Mayo. You know, not a big sporting event day, Cinco de Mayo. Not the big sporting event day. But, of course, it's bigger brother, it's sibling, the Kentucky Derby. That, of course, happened. And Mystic Dan got it done. First time in a long time that the Kentucky Derby was actually exciting. We had to go to a photo finish. Can you imagine back in the day when you had to wait for the photo to develop? Remember that? You probably maybe don't. We had to go to the photo hut. We had to get that thing developed quickly. You had to wait around a while we had the photos developed so we could tell who won the photo finish. Well, it was a photo finish, three wide photo finish. And exciting for the first time in a long time, the Kentucky Derby getting it done with Mystic Dan there. I actually was partially interested. You know, I'm not really a big horse racing guy. We've tried before. We talked about it on the show. I'm just not a big horse racing guy. But you get finishes like that, that makes it a little bit more exciting. Maybe not as exciting as a finish in NASCAR, right? Maybe not as exciting. I don't know. Kyle Larson edging Chris Buescher at the line to win at Kansas. That was pretty exciting. You listen to all those races on our sister station, Big Buck Country, 101.5. So coming up on the show, again, we got Brooklyn Ulrich coming up in the next few minutes. We're going to hear from her. And then a little bit later on, Bub Feringa. We're talking softball today, but we're going to hear from you. Let's get those texts in, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Some staff changes for Marshall Volleyball. We'll get into a little bit of that later on. Also, the roster building has begun for the TBT. Yes, the tournament that saved us so many years ago in COVID when we had nothing, and I mean nothing to talk about, but still we're obligated to do the show. The TBT is back. The roster is being built. We'll tell you who's on the roster. Familiar name, you know who it is. We'll talk about it, though, when we continue with this edition of The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
Giovanni's has great Italian dishes. Spaghetti with meat sauce, lasagna, ravioli, manicotti, all dinners served with hot garlic bread or Italian rolls. Giovanni's, the Italian place to be.
Are you looking for furniture, electronics, appliances, or computers? Maybe you're looking for something special like jewelry, lawnmowers, gun safes, grills, or kayaks. What if I told you could find all of that in one place? Because you can, at Aaron's. Aaron's has almost anything. If it makes your room complete, if it improves your life, if it upgrades your hobby, or if it makes you smile, you'll find it at Aaron's, and you'll find it at an affordable price. Shop Aaron's today at 2626 Fifth Avenue in Huntington and 3050 Walnut Street in Portsmouth. You'll find it at Aaron's.
Sunflower Seeds will host an I Run Walk for Ukraine 5K Saturday, May 18th at Ritter Park. It starts at 9 o'clock. Visit tristateracer.com to register. T-shirts, canvas bags, and other items. Part of the $25 pre-registration fee. Sunflower Seeds Incorporated is a tri-state area nonprofit established to raise awareness and resources for humanitarian aid to Ukrainian refugees. 17 million Ukrainians are in need of aid, and most of the refugees are women and children who want to remain near their Ukrainian homeland. To date, Sunflower Seeds has raised $40,000, and over 13,000 pounds of food and medical supplies have been delivered across six trips to Poland and beyond. Again, to be part of this I Run Walk for Ukraine 5K, May 18th at Ritter Park, at 9 o'clock, visit tristateracer.com to register.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
Coming up this week, the 2024 Sun Belt Softball Championship is going to be held in San Marcos, Texas. The Thundering Herd drew the 10 seed and will take on number 7 seed Georgia Southern. That's going to be 7 o'clock on Wednesday. And joining us now on the program is Brooklyn Ulrich. She is the RBI leader in the Sun Belt. And Brooklyn now joins us on the program. congratulations. That's a pretty impressive title to be so successful this year. What do you attribute that success last year? Close, but not close enough. I'm sure you would have liked to have been a lot better last year, but this year you've really improved in so many facets. You know, what do you attribute that turnaround to?
Yes, I do think it's a complete 180 from last year. I was batting 189, I believe is what it was. And now I'm batting about 400. So that's a great change. I would say the confidence that my coaching staff is giving me to just get in the box. And I know that now after that fall training that we had for this year, I can hit any pitch near the zone. It's just about being selective of what pitches I hit. And I feel that Coach Z and the other coaches of the coaching staff really have just instilled confidence in me that I have a great swing and that we don't need to change anything for my swing. We just have to change my approach when I get in the box.
Is that the only thing that's changed? Maybe just how they approach it? And you have a coaching change. Obviously, something's going to change.
Yeah.
You know, what do you think is maybe different and what's connecting for you that maybe didn't last year from the previous staff?
So this year, Coach Z, not once has she tried to completely scratch my swing and completely change it just in one practice. We have worked to go after pitchers in a different kind of light, like the angle of which our bat is. Last year, I felt that my swing was constantly changing and it was completely different every single day when I stepped out on the field, and I wasn't 100% sure what kind of swing I was going to get that day and what kind of changes were going to be made to it. Not to discredit that hitting coach, but that style just has never worked for me. I'm definitely a build from your swing kind of person. So I feel that Zirkle has really made it easy for me in that sense.
My guest getting set for the Sun Belt Conference Championships that's coming up in San Marcos, Texas, is the Sun Belt RBI leader. That's doesn't get old to say, Brooklyn Ulrich. And you've got a tough task ahead of you. You come in as the 10 seed. That's something that historically Marshall doesn't do, come in as a low seed. Last year, so close to winning the Sun Belt Conference Championship. This year, you got to do it a little harder this time, being a 10 seed. Does that give you a little added motivation, a little chip on your shoulder, knowing that you've been close to the top before and the way the regular season finished, that this is your great opportunity to turn it around?
Yeah, it's definitely motivation. And it's also an opportunity for us to show that, hey, we can come back. Even though we are the 10 seed, even though we didn't have the best record this year, that doesn't determine whether or not we're going to win these next upcoming games and how far we're going to make it. Because softball rewards good people, and we are good people.
Does it help that you played a few days ago where you're playing now? You get a feel for the venue. I know neutral sites.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, everybody's got to play on a neutral site, and eventually you've seen it the way conference play goes. But you've just recently seen it, and you've acclimated. How much of an advantage does that give you going into this?
It is a lot. I mean, seeing how the ball, for like ground balls, at least from the infield, I know from that standpoint, seeing how the ball moves and whether it takes certain hops and et cetera, and also the air here. The ball isn't flying as much as it would if we were in Huntington. So that's a good observation that we've made, that we need to hit lower line drives and aim from left center to right center. So it's given us a good feel for how we need to hit the ball and how we need to field the ball.
Is there any different approach you take now that you are in conference tournament play? You have a team that you won a series against recently. That was in Huntington. It's conference time, though. You don't go back to the film and look at that, right? You just get ready and you try to work on yourself. Is that how it goes?
So right now we're looking at film from the pitchers that were thrown against us whenever we played them in our series. And personally, and I know for some of the other girls on the team, we're just going to go at this game just like it's another game. The more pressure we put on ourselves and the more pressure that we put that this is a super important game, normally you're not going to have the best result. So we're just going to go at it like, hey, we know how to play softball. We know how to do this thing. And we're just going to go out and play and do what we do.
So you're just looking at them. It's not, hey, this is a conference game for the right to advance. This is, okay, this is just the next opponent. So nothing changes really. It's more consistency that you're looking forward.
Right. We're gonna have the mindset that we want to win just like how we did for every other game. The more pressure that we put on ourselves for this game, the harder it'll be for us like the more stressful it can make it for us. So we're just going to go in saying, hey, we know what they're going to throw us. We know what their hitting lineup shows. Like, we got this. We just need to play defense, pitch, and hit.
Have you had to be a little bit more vocal now being a veteran on this team with the new players coming in? This will be the first time for a lot of them in a tournament atmosphere like a conference championship. You know, what have you had to do as far as one of the veterans on this team now to step up? Have you become more vocal? You know, are you being more hands-on with people? You know, how are you approaching this?
I feel that I've always been a very vocal kind of player ever since I got here my freshman year. And obviously that did not end up the best because I redshirted. But last year I was very vocal as a sophomore redshirt freshman. And this year I feel that I'm the exact same way. I don't take it as like I'm a captain. I do feel that I am a leader on the team. I lead by example. And also I feel that I bring great energy and positive energy to the field, and people gravitate towards that.
My guest, Brooklyn Ulrich, getting set for the Sun Belt Softball Championship in San Marcos, Texas, taking on Georgia Southern. So what do we know about Georgia Southern? What's changed since the last time you faced them?
Georgia Southern, so they're going to probably throw their number one. So she's in the lower 60s when she throws, and she throws a lot of curves. So I'm going to be ready for that ball to be left middle of the plate because the curveball starts away for a left-handed hitter and comes to the inside. So I'm just going to be ready to attack that one. That one's going to be the pitch.
You anticipate any changes, lineup, as far as try to be, give them a little different look?
Lineup's probably going to be consistent to what our last games were. I believe that when we played them, when we played Georgia Southern, I think I was further down in the lineup. I think it was either 4 or 5, something like that. I think we're going to stick with me being leadoff and then Bella right behind me. Bella's a great hitter. And when I get on base, normally she scores me. She's also tied with me for RBIs for the season. So she's been a great addition to our team.
So you're more comfortable in that position now.
Yeah, I'm very comfortable in that position. I know I have some great hitters right behind me in the lineup, and that definitely gives me confidence as a leadoff.
If you look at this team, you don't look at the record necessarily. You look at how successful you've been as far as hitting.
Right.
And you've had the hitting. You've had that success. You're leading the league in that category, which is important. What do you think is missing to take it to the next level, to the next step?
I think that we're great at getting on base and getting hits individually. The only part that we struggle with is like executing when we have runners in scoring position or just runners on. A lot of the time there will be a leadoff to, let's just say, the fourth inning, and that runner might just get stranded either at second or at third base, and we don't execute getting the runs in. We do leave a lot of runners on, and I think that's definitely what makes it harder for us to win games, because we'll hit the ball. We'll get on base. We just have trouble scoring.
My guest, Marshall standout Brooklyn Ulrich. She is leading the league in RBI. And a fun fact about her, she lettered in varsity in badminton high school.
Yeah, I did. Yes.
What's the story there? Badminton to softball. That's a different journey.
I know.
Journey.
What a change. Right. Badminton was just a fun sport to do. One of the assistant coaches for my high school team, he was a badminton coach, and they needed more players, and he thought I would be a great candidate because I like to try new things, and I'm pretty adaptable when it comes to new sports in that kind of area. So recruited me. I spent the whole summer leading up to my junior year in high school at the badminton like summer camp kind of deal. So it was like for 3 hours Monday through Friday in the morning at like 8 a.m. until 11. And he taught me how to play badminton. I ended up, the highest position I made it was varsity 3. And then I stayed at varsity 4 for most of the year.
You miss it? Do you try to go back to it? Do you think maybe you're going to go into pickleball next?
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I love pickleball. We have some pickleball courts over by my house in Huntington, but my roommate and friend Bub, she also played badminton and she does pickleball a lot.
We're going to talk to her as well. So, okay, that's a good fact to have.
Yes.
Who's better, you or Bub?
At pickleball?
Yes.
Bub. At badminton, I'd crush Bub any day of the week. And she's sitting right next to me, so
okay.
I can say that.
Sounds like a challenge. So after all this is done, I think we're going to have that badminton challenge between you and Bub.
That's exactly what I'm saying. I agree.
Let's make it happen. Brooklyn Ulrich with us. Good luck. Congratulations. It's going to be a fun tournament, I hope, for you. And we'll hopefully be talking about a championship next week for Marshall softball.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Brooklyn. When we continue, we're going to hear from Bub Feringa. We're going to find out if that badminton challenge is going to be accepted when we continue on this edition of The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
Buddy's All-American Barbecue is now in Milton. Enjoy all your favorite Buddy's classics like pulled pork, brisket, ribs, and more on East Main Street in Milton. Buddy's All-American Barbecue, the home of great barbecue, ice-cold beer, and killer wings in Huntington and now in Milton.
Save big money and transform your home with new appliances now at Menards. We offer the lowest prices and the largest in-stock appliance selection ready to take home today. Check out top appliance brands, including KitchenAid, Maytag, Whirlpool, Amana, and Criterion. Upgrade your home and save big money on new appliances at Menards. Shop our entire selection of appliance options online today at Menards.com.
Save big money at Menards.
America Strong. It's what we're all about. And to keep America strong, all Glockner locations are offering our lowest live market prices so you save big. And with our partnership with Kelley Blue Book, the Glockner buying centers are able to offer $2,000 above current market value for your current vehicle. That's how we're keeping America strong at the Glockner family of dealerships.
We make it easy at Glockner.com.
The more vulnerable among us can fall victim to abuse, neglect, and financial exploitation. When navigating your way out, it doesn't have to feel like a maze. Assistance is available from Adult Protective Services. To report neglect or abuse, call 800-352-6513. Sponsored by the Administration for Community Living, West Virginia Department of Health and Human Resources Bureau for Social Services, the West Virginia Broadcasters Association, and this station.
This project was supported by the Administration for Community Living, ACL, and the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, HHS, as part of a financial assistance award totaling $383,493, with 75% funded by ACL-HHS and 25% in the amount of $85,236 funded by state government sources. The contents are those of the authors and do not necessarily represent the official views of nor an endorsement by ACL-HHS or the U.S. government.
Sunflower Seeds will host an I Run Walk for Ukraine 5K Saturday, May 18th at Ritter Park. Starts at 9 o'clock. Visit TriStateRacer.com to register. T-shirts, canvas bags, and other items. Part of the $25 pre-registration fee. Sunflower Seeds Incorporated is a tri-state area nonprofit established to raise awareness and resources for humanitarian aid to Ukrainian refugees. 17 million Ukrainians are in need of aid, and most of the refugees are women and children who want to remain near their Ukrainian homeland. To date, Sunflower Seeds has raised $40,000, and over 13,000 pounds of food and medical supplies have been delivered across six trips to Poland and beyond. Again, to be part of this I Run Walk for Ukraine 5K, May 18th at Ritter Park, 9 o'clock, visit TriStateRacer.com to register.
Buddy's All-American Barbecue is now in Milton. Enjoy all your favorite Buddy's classics like pulled pork, brisket, ribs, and more on East Main Street in Milton. Buddy's All-American Barbecue, the home of great barbecue, ice-cold beer, and killer wings in Huntington and now in Milton.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
We continue with our softball preview. The Thundering Herd, the 10 seed, coming up. It's the 2024 Sun Belt Softball Championship in San Marcos, Texas. And the Thundering Herd will face off against the 7 seed Georgia Southern. That's coming up on Wednesday. And joining us now on the program is Bub Feringa. Bub, thanks for being a part of the show. And Bub got called out earlier on the show by her friend Brooklyn Ulrich. It sounds like we're going to have to set up a badminton championship here real soon between you and her and throw in a little pickleball as well. I mean, can you focus on the game ahead with Georgia Southern, knowing that you've got that challenge in the back of your mind waiting?
Oh, yeah.
She said that she would crush you in badminton.
Yeah, I think it'll be a good match between us. I think we've played every now and then, just over the summer and stuff when we hung out in Arizona, but I think it'll be a good match coming up.
Now, she mentioned you play that as well, so I'm just curious, the transition from badminton to softball, that had to be an interesting turn of events.
Oh, yeah. It actually kind of helped on both sides. So my badminton coach was actually a softball coach, too. So a lot of the terms and movements and stuff actually like correlated and translated to softball. So like drop steps and like all that kind of thing. It actually kind of helped me move quicker on the field, in the infield and everything. So, and that eye-hand coordination too is just really, really helped out. So
you recommend all aspiring softball players to play badminton and pickleball?
Yeah, I mean, do what you can, but it's really fun.
Now, last year, let's talk about how you've progressed. Last year, you only threw 10 innings. Now you lead the team in innings pitched, and I don't mean by a small margin. You know, you have definitely taken the reins of this team. Talk about your progress from going from, you know, only 10 innings to leading the team and being the workhorse of this team.
Yeah, we had Sid graduate, and then those innings opened up, and so I kind of just worked over the summer. Got to play in the Florida League and work on some of my pitches and everything, and came in the fall and got to work with Coach Al for a couple months. So that was really fun, and put a lot of hard work into like investing in her thought process and spins of pitches and speeds of pitches. So it's really been working out.
Was it stressful? Was there a lot of pressure on you, or did that even go into your process, knowing that, okay, now that Sydney Nestor's gone, I've got to step up and I got to take the lead here. You know, what was that process like as you were stepping into that void?
Just kind of filled with excitement. I mean, getting to play on the field, having the infield returning from behind her, so I know they were going to do a good job, and just kind of trusting the people I have around me to just help me get better and just have fun playing with them.
What's changed for you since last year? You had Coach Smith Lyon, this year Coach Zirkle, Coach Z. What's changed for you as far as the process? What's been the same? What's been different as you have improved and had more opportunity?
Not much. I mean, both are pretty empowering coaches, very confident in what they believe in and what they do. And so it's kind of just adjusting to just the newness of someone after you've been coached by them for 2 years, and just kind of just embracing the new of this year and what they brought. So
did it help having that consistency, knowing that you're going from one good coach like Coach Smith Lyon to Coach Z, who also knows what she's doing? Everybody loves her. She's well regarded. So you didn't feel that there was a complete drastic transition or changeover? It's just the consistency maybe helped more?
Oh, no. I think just the confidence that Coach Z brought into this team, and just the excitement and the knowledge that she brought is just really exciting.
My guest, Bub Feringa, she is getting set for Sunbelt softball action. You've got Georgia Southern coming up on Wednesday. You've handled them before. They were back in Huntington in March. You won that series. As you get ready for Georgia Southern, what's your process like as you get set to take them on? This is a single elimination tournament, but you got to treat it as just another game, right?
Oh, yeah. We got all the film we have on them, and just studying it up and just trusting what we've been preparing in the last couple weeks. I mean, we've been heating up on both sides of the on the field and in the circle, so it's going to be really exciting this week.
Even though you didn't win the series, did it help knowing that you'd have a few extra days in Texas to get ready, not only for the tournament, but at the same time, the venue? You don't go into this completely unaware of your situation. You know, you've been there now a few days. You kind of have a feel what the field's all about.
Oh, yeah. The air is way different here. Ball doesn't hardly fly, so that's good on the pitching aspect, but hitting, we kind of just got to stick to low line drives and hard ground balls through the infield. So
what do you know about Georgia Southern? What have you looked at them? You know, I know you can't really rely on the last encounter, but what do you see from them? What's maybe the same? What's changed about them as you get set to try to beat them?
They're also kind of heating up. They've won a majority of their last couple games. So this, we know their hitters are going to attack strikes in the zone. So we just got to make those as competitive as possible. And just in the box, we just got to swing at strikes and trust our swings and just string everything together.
My guest, Bub Feringa, getting set for the Sunbelt Softball Championship. Georgia Southern, if you get past them, I know you can't look ahead, but it's nice to know you know what the path looks like.
Oh, yeah. If we get to play Texas State again, I guarantee it'll be a much more competitive game than what some of the weekend series scores look like, but we're excited and we're ready.
What's been fun so far on this trip? I know with a few extra days, this isn't like a normal road trip for you. You come in, you play, and then you pretty much leave. You've had that extra time. You know, how have you taken advantage of that, and has it been beneficial knowing that you go from playing Texas State to sticking around and then getting ready to play your next opponent, and you don't have to travel far?
Yeah, I mean, long trips like these are always hard, but we've been finding some fun things to do. We're about to go shopping at the outlets. We just got done having lunch together after we practiced, so just finding little things to do.
Is it something that is important with all of this extra time? You can't practice all the time, so is it important knowing that you've got this extended stay to kind of stay focused at the same time? Just enjoy the trip.
Oh, yeah. Just getting our work done when we can and then just making the most of our time outside the field. But, yeah.
Would you prefer to maybe play somebody else and then travel? Or are you happy the way the regular season ended with really just going back to your room and getting set for the next game?
I think it kind of worked out for us. I know last year at Louisiana, we kind of just made it another weekend series. But with a trip like this, we just got to stay focused for a little bit longer than usual, but kind of just resetting before playing again.
Bub Feringa's with us, getting set for the Sun Belt Softball Championship in San Marcos, Texas. So you come in as a 10 seed. When you hear Marshall as a 10 seed, what goes through your mind?
We got a lot to prove.
That's not a position that Marshall's been in for a long time, being a 10 seed. It's not Marshall softball as far as seeding concerned. So when you say there's a lot to prove, you know, is that because of the seeding so low, or is that because you want to feel like you got to finish strong? You know, what are you trying to prove?
You know, just showing everybody like how hurt softball knows how to play, good defense, great hitting, strong pitching. Just having all three aspects of those games throughout this week is going to be really big for us.
Is there that proverbial chip on your shoulder to use that as extra motivation? You know, does that even come to mind as far as, okay, we're a 10 seed? You know, how do you use that? Or do you just go out and do what you need to do and not worry about where you're at?
I think we're just going to go out there and not worry where we're at this week. We've played the teams we know coming up pretty tough every time, so we know what we're going to get, and we just got to go out there and play how we know how to play.
My guest, Bub Feringa, Sun Belt Softball Championship coming up. It's going to be Wednesday versus Georgia Southern. Thundering Herd looking to advance. Good luck, Bub. I hope everything works out. We're talking about the Sun Belt Championship next week, because after that, we've got a badminton and a pickleball tournament to talk about here.
Oh, yeah. Thank you so much.
I appreciate it. Thanks, Bub. We'll open up our text line when we continue. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. More on this edition of The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
Giovanni's Pizza. Fresh, hot, and tasty. Have it delivered right to your door. Giovanni's. The Italian place to be.
There's a chill in the air at GoMart as we start our spooky summer savings early. Throughout May, we're teaming up with Ghost Energy to bring you spooky bonus reward points with the GoMart Ghost Hunt. Join the hunt to earn reward points and a game token with your Ghost Energy purchase. The top 25 reward point earners will receive a bone-chilling 5,000 bonus points. Imagine all the ghouly treats you can grab with those points. Just head over to the GoMart app for all the spine-tingling details.
When Cynthia came to TurboTax, she had just launched her new side gig, a true crime podcast.
I'm a first-rate detective with a golden voice.
As her TurboTax expert, I made her second income count by guaranteeing 100% accurate filing and her maximum refund.
What did she do with that refund? Find out next week.
Switch to Intuit TurboTax and make your moves count. See guarantee details at TurboTax.com/guarantees. Experts only available with TurboTax Live.
Hey there, baseball fans. Are you craving a home run of flavor? Step up to the plate and swing for the fences with sliders from the Marshall Hall of Fame Cafe. Whether you're a fan of French dip, fried bologna, Reuben, or Southern fried chicken, the Marshall Cafe has sliders that'll knock it out of the park. Each order comes with a side of fries, rounding out your winning lineup.
Hey, make me out to the ball game.
Slide into Flavortown with sliders from the Marshall Hall of Fame Cafe on the corner of Fun and 3rd Avenue, downtown Huntington.
May is National Electrical Safety Month, and First Energy's Potomac Edison and Mon Power are here with outdoor safety tips. Keep away from power lines, overhead and underground. Always call 811 before you dig. Don't fly drones or kites near power lines, and if one crashes into an electric facility, call your local power company and don't try to retrieve it yourself. For more safety tips, visit firstenergycorp.com/safety. This message sponsored by First Energy, the West Virginia Broadcasters Association, and this station.
Planning for a funeral is never easy, and selecting the right mortuary can be important. Family owned and operated for over 6 decades, our family has helped other families going through the most difficult time. Chapman's Mortuary and Crematory can help you plan arrangements today or offer a pre-need funeral plan in line with your intimate wishes. And now, we provide Huntington's only on-site crematory. Call us for a free consultation. Chapman's Mortuary and Crematory, serving the tri-state for over 60 years.
Linda Ashley, a proud graduate of Marshall University and CEO of Poca Valley Bank, wishes the Marshall baseball team a great season. At Poca Valley Bank, we believe in the power of community banking. Our team is dedicated to serving you, our neighbors, with personalized financial solutions tailored to meet your needs. Together, let's build a stronger, more prosperous future for our community. Visit us today at PocaValleyBank.com or call us at 844-782-2651 and become part of the Poca Valley family. Poca Valley Bank, where relationships matter. Member FDIC.
Now at Menards, save big money on everything for your next project. For 65 years, Menards has been the destination for post-frame buildings. Whether it's used for protecting equipment or you just need a place to keep your toys, Menards has a post-frame building option for you. Get a free estimate fast, in-store or online at Menards.com. Plus, check out the weekly flyer for other great deals happening now.
Save big money at Menards.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
Welcome back. It is the Monday edition of The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. I'm your host, Paul Swann. Our text line this hour is 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. We got a lot of comments the other day off of recruiting Cade and Jacob Gibbs coming to the Thundering Herd. A lot of people were maybe not impressed that they came from the NAIA rankings. I mean, they're... And so we got a lot of feedback on that, and we'll get more of that here in a minute. A couple people already texted in. I want to talk a little bit more about that because recruiting's still the big story when it comes to Marshall basketball. Texter writes in and says they would like to get a bruiser to help Nate Martin in the paint. Appreciate that text. Yeah, I'd like to see a little stronger in the paint as well. And I know there's been some concern that, okay, maybe Marshall's not going to be able to attract some of the better names in basketball. And they've got a year of eligibility, the Gibbs brothers do, and they're Indiana natives. Grace College, Lancers are kind of a well-known NAIA program. So there was a lot of concern about that. That was something we're going to keep an eye on as far as what's the rest of the recruiting class going to look like? What's the rest of the transfer portal class going to look like when we get to the finish line on this thing? Now the portal's closed. Now it's just finding the right fit for the Thundering Herd. One thing we don't have to worry about, the transfer portal and the NFL, that's a little bit different. Over the weekend, some of the numbers were coming out. Ethan Driscoll, of course, being drafted by the Kansas City Chiefs. Rasheen Ali being picked up by the Baltimore Ravens. Rasheen's going to be number 26 for the Ravens, so start getting those jerseys now. Rasheen, 26, and then Ethan Driscoll with the Chiefs, going to be number 75. So a lot of former Marshall players, when able to, will choose the number 75 just to show their support for Marshall fans. And, of course, I know a lot of Herd fans were excited to see that. So you might see a lot of Kansas City Chiefs 75 jerseys floating around here in the next few weeks when those things become available. I'm sure we're going to see a little influx of Ravens gear as well. Not me. Nope. Sticking with my Bengals gear when it comes to the NFL. But that was pretty cool to see. Driscoll, number 75. I'm sure he had maybe a little influence in that and said, look, Is 75 available? They maybe were signing into numbers like, yeah, can I get 75? I'm sure that just didn't randomly come up. If it did, it's quite a random occurrence, and he probably was smiling when it happened. But 75 is definitely going to be a number that comes up a lot for Marshall football players when that number is available. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. What's happening with the Thundering Herd? Well, got softball getting ready for the conference tournament. We got baseball still a couple weeks ago. I mean, Thundering Herd got 2 out of 3 this weekend on the baseball diamond. Thankfully, the weather let the Herd get some games in. Yeah, that's going to be a problem for years to come, but Marshall was able to get some things in just before it wrapped up. Maybe not a good showing on Sunday, but yeah, I think depth is going to be a big issue moving forward for Marshall baseball. Volleyball making some news today. The Thundering Herd announcing addition of a couple of assistant coaches. First up will be Heather Stout. She was the head coach at Catholic University of America for the last 3 years. They are a Division III program, so she is stepping up to Division I. And so they are a program that has shown improvement. They went from 8-23 to 20-12 over her 3 seasons. So they definitely made some strides, and now she's on the staff. And then a name you probably already know, Caitlin Geller. She was hired as the director of operations in 2023. And, of course, she played for the Thundering Herd as well. So her transition continues from player, director of operations. Now she is on the staff as an assistant coach. It's pretty cool because she can get out there and still probably show them how it's done. I like to see sometimes coaches go up against their players, kind of just like, okay, do it this way. And they can actually go out there and show them how it's done. Another guy that shows them how it's done, Jared West. TBT is coming up sooner than you think. And, of course, the TBT made a serious run last year with the Thundering Herd featured. So Jared West returning to the team. First, I'm sure, of many announcements that will be coming up. How excited do you get over the TBT? There were a lot of people that were following along last year and making the travel plans to go see the TBT. If that thing would have been in Charleston last year, I think it would have been a better tournament. I know they moved it, different venue. I didn't agree with that. I thought Charleston was a good venue for it. It's centrally located, so that gives fans of Best Virginia and Herd that an equal opportunity. You know, maybe more so for Marshall fans and West Virginia fans, at least in the Morgantown area. But I didn't agree with that thing being moved out of Charleston. If you're going to move it in state, I think you have to have it in Charleston. I don't think it works at the Coliseum. I mean, sure, Best Virginia would love to play in the Coliseum, but I wonder if you had that in the Coliseum, would more fans be willing to travel to see Best Virginia and maybe heard that in the Coliseum? Now, if you had it in Henderson Center, how many Marshall fans would show up to watch Herd that? Could you get 3,000? Could you get 4,000? Could you get 5,000? What would it look like if Marshall was able to get the TBT to come to Huntington? And of course, Thundering Herd able to make a run last year. I think that piqued a lot of people's interest. And that's the thing for me. This thing saved us during COVID. It saved us. There was not much going on, and we had the TBT. So now the TBT getting ready to go once again. So we're going to open our text line up for you. If you haven't already, jump in, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. That's our text line to be a part of tonight's edition of The Drive here at ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. Busy night last night. NBA, Cleveland, as we mentioned earlier, advancing to the Eastern Conference semifinals, beat the Magic in Game 7, 106-94. And the Cavs had to make it dramatic. They trailed in the first half by 18 points. And then, without LeBron James, let's highlight that, without LeBron James, Cleveland comes back. It's the largest comeback for the Cavaliers in a Game 7 since the league began tracking that. And I knew they hadn't won a series since LeBron James, but we got to go all the way back to 1993 for the last time that the Cavaliers won a playoff series without LeBron James. Not just ever, but without LeBron James. LeBron comes in, makes Cleveland a contender automatically. Yeah, LeBron doesn't have that ability in him anymore. He needs help. You look at the Lakers, definitely need some help surrounding him. But at the time, Cleveland, it was futility, 1993, and then LeBron comes in. Now the Cavs will start on the road. They'll take on the team I love to hate, the Boston Celtics. Boston was actually pretty successful against the Cavs this season, 2-1. I'm not necessarily a Cavs guy, but I'm not a Boston guy either. I definitely root against Boston. Yeah, that's where I'm at tonight. I'm gonna root against Boston, definitely. NBA tonight, game one of the Eastern semifinals. Pacers taking on the Knicks tonight. Go Knicks! I don't have the Lakers anymore. I got to take a team. Go Knicks! And West semis are coming up tonight. Timberwolves taking on the Denver Nuggets. And, of course, yesterday was a fun day in the National Hockey League because we had a get this. We had a round two game start, and we had the conclusion of the final round one game as the Stars eliminated the Golden Knights yesterday 2-1. Rangers in round two in the East got a very hotly contested game against the Carolina Hurricanes 4-3. Fun stuff. Coming up, we've got Boston taking on Florida, the second round two game. That's coming up tonight at 8 o'clock. Bruins and Panthers should be a fun one. Again, I'm not picking Boston. I got to root against Boston. Whatever the sport. Baseball, I'm rooting against Boston. Football, I'm rooting against the teams that they love in Boston. Baseball, definitely. Basketball, yeah. Hockey, all of that. I'm rooting against Boston. They're just so easy to root against. I'm not even a Panthers fan. To be honest with you, I'm not a Pacers fan either, so it's easier for me. I don't know who I would take, Timberwolves or Nuggets. I don't know who probably the Timberwolves. In the semis, I would take the Timberwolves tonight. I'm going to take the Knicks tonight as well in all of that. And I'm taking the Celtics, even though I'm not rooting for them. I'm taking the Celtics. That's going to be I think that series goes six. Celtics, I think they go six. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255 from our text line. Texter writes in and says, I'm taking the Knicks tonight, and they go five, and I'm taking the Timberwolves, and they go seven. Okay, I'm good with that. I'd go with that as well. Texter writes in and says, I'm taking the Cavs. They're going to go to the championship. They're going to shock the world. I am not going with that, but all right. I'll take that. I'll take that under advisement. Could you imagine the Cavs could get to the championship the first time since LeBron James? You could see the Cavaliers in the championship. LeBron's at home working on some project, not basketball. Who would have thought that the Cavaliers would last longer than LeBron James in the postseason? I'm starting to think it's getting time for LeBron to find a situation where he can get some help. He might have to take a pay cut. I don't know. If you got to pay LeBron James, I don't know how much you got left to pay everybody else. Texter writes in and says, not taking the Cavs to go past Boston. That other texter is crazy. I appreciate that. Thanks for tuning in. No, there's some Cavaliers fans around here. I was surprised by that. As bad as the Cavs have ever been. And these were Cavs fans before LeBron James. That's the thing that surprised me. I was not expecting that. I mean, come on. It's the Cavs. They haven't been good in a long time. And that was before LeBron. And then everybody jumped on the Cavs bandwagon when LeBron was bringing them to some level of consistency there. I never jumped on that Cavaliers bandwagon. I mean, I'm a Lakers fan, not necessarily a big fan of LeBron. I mean, when they won the championship, I was all for it. But at the same time, wasn't a big fan of LeBron. I don't know if he's going to – and that wasn't necessarily a normal situation in which the Lakers won that championship. But I don't know if LeBron's – going to be able to bring it the way he used to. And for what you're paying him, what do you get out of LeBron? I mean, would you be better to use that to get some younger talent, free up the cap space a little bit to bring in younger talent you could build around? I mean, I think gone are the days you bring in a superstar like LeBron James. I mean, because he can still go, but I don't think he can do it all by himself. That's okay. The team that drafts Bronny is going to get him anyway. Would you do that? like, hey, we can let LeBron James. We're just going to take our draft pick and draft his son. Would you make that? Would you absolutely pull the trigger on that and say, okay, we're going to give up a draft pick for LeBron James' son so we can get LeBron James? And I don't, unless you're just propping up your franchise, just propping them up. Like, we're going to be terrible anyway. Let's just go ahead and do it. People will buy tickets. What if Cleveland drafted Bronny and then LeBron goes back to Cleveland? I would need an ironclad deal in place. It's like, look, we're drafting Bronny, but you better be ready to come. You better be ready to come, and you better be affordable. We'll draft him. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Texter writes in, did you get a trophy and make the soccer coach jealous? I don't think Chris Grassy's jealous. I'm sitting there thinking, is Chris Grassy jealous? He's got a room for trophies. He's good. Yes, I did win something recently. Thank you for checking in. I don't think Chris is jealous. That's going to do it for this edition. Thanks for tuning in here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. I want to thank our producer tonight. We're training him now. Some of you have been mad because you can't call in, and you said, go get an intern. So we got an intern. Once we get him trained, we'll take some phone calls here over this next couple of months. So give me a few days. We'll get him trained. Ben Anderson's joining us. Mr. Anderson for the next couple of months. So we'll have an intern here in the summer months, or at least the early summer months, and we'll get some of your calls in. But keep those texts coming in. We'll do that again tomorrow here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. Have a great night, everyone.
Transmitting in glorious FM on 94.1 W227BS Huntington. This is 930 WRVC Huntington, celebrating 100 years of broadcasting.
West Virginia Metro News, I'm Jarrett Lewis. U.S. Attorney for the Southern District, Will Thompson, says another key member of a drug trafficking organization